Hey guys, what's going on? John here from What's Spinning, here tonight to chat about this new album from the Wytches. It's called 3 Mile Ditch. Wytches are a UK-based garage rock band who I discovered at the peak of my curiosity of super campy psychedelic rock and garage rock bands like Ty Segall and the OCs, as well as my heightened obsession for all things spooky and campy. And their debut album, Annabelle Dream Rider, scratched just about every itch I had at the time. It was grimy, noisy, and wild, but it was also a little dramatic and campy. It was just so incredibly over the top. However, their follow-up album, All Your Happy Life, while it brought in a lot of interesting other genres of music like surf rock, honestly, I felt like it was a little bit more hit and miss. A lot of the material here just sounded so uninspired and burnt out. Now, it's been a while. I mean a while. It's been like 4 years since we heard from these guys. But to be honest, these singles that they've been dropping leading up to this album have been some of my favorite in rock all year. Let's chat about this thing. This album starts off with Cowboy. Right off the bat, it's a lot heavier than I remember and a lot bluesier than I remember. It almost reminds me of like what the Black Lips were doing around the time of their Good, Bad, Not Evil album. It's just so drawn out. It just has this, feeling of just exhaustion and emotion. And you know what? It's a really great sound for them. Now let's address real quick the elephant in the room. This is far from the campy, horror-based garage rock they were putting out years ago. But it's much more human, and in a way it's even more gutting and visceral than some of their early stuff. Not to mention, I kind of like the weird, campy southern twang to this blues rock that they're putting out. It's really a great emotional intro. Then we have this album's title track, 3 Mile Ditch, and I gotta tell you, I love the sound on this track. It just sounds like the Wytches have been traveling for miles, driving for miles, and they're just about to run out of gas, and they are exhausted. But not in a boring way, it just kind of sounds like they're just putting everything, every last ounce of their energy into this. It's bluesy, it's dreary, it's a little psychedelic, which are things you can say about the majority of this album. I don't know what I was expecting from this album, but this actually reminds me a lot of what I was listening to in high school. Not to mention, it gets really heavy towards the end. I mean, personally, I thought the Wytches needed a shift going into this album, and this is a good one. Midnight Ride, on the other hand, took a little while to grow on me. It's just this very dreary, meditative, psychedelic rock-tinged track. In a weird way, it sounds almost like a forgotten single from the 60s that went unnoticed that I would have ranted and raved about in high school. It's super delicate, but I love just how misty it sounds and how heartbroken. It's actually pretty breathtaking, and I love the strings here. Now, because it's not as heavy or as blues-inspired as the rest of the tracks here, this took a little bit more to grow on me, but still is a great sound. Fly Inside is a little bit more jittery, a little bit more lively, but I love the bluesy riff and the tortured vocals. Vocally might be my favorite track of the album. Like, every time this chorus rolls around, they sound absolutely exhausted, and I love it. And I love how chaotic and colorful it is. It sounds like these instrumentals are getting into a fight with one another, bashing off each other constantly, and it's pretty exciting. Sadly, I do feel like the second half of the album is not nearly as consistent as the first. Everyone's Friend is a major letdown here. I don't mind the jagged riffs and the sort of post-hardcore inspired breakdowns we get here. That's totally fine. But it's the incredibly bored, uninspired vocals here that just fly right by me. For all the tracks here that sound like exciting, colorful jams, this is not one of them. And Silver Trees misses the mark for me too. As a matter of fact, it's my least favorite track here. I'm not opposed to a lighter track from the Wytches. There are much better on this album. It's just so light and flaky though. It just sounds like it could crumble at any minute. It's easily the most boring track here. Not only that, there's been like a subtle nod to classic rock and classic psychedelic rock on this album. This just sounds like a blatant ripoff. And while You Looked Happy to Me isn't the worst thing going on here, it does miss the mark with me a little bit. I do really like some of the visual lyrics on this track, and the instrumental's fine. But I don't know what happened to the great, emotional, exhausted, burnt-out feel of the first half of the album. The songwriting on this track is garbage. To me, this sounds like a track that would have came out years ago and every blog in the blogosphere would have bashed for sounding way too much like every other garage punk band. I mean, when some of the crashing, wailing guitars come in towards the end, yeah, there are some exciting moments. but I just kind of wish that this album finished as strongly as it started. Outside of that, this may not be the Wytches you remember from a few years ago, but this is a pretty solid new sound from them. A Love You'll Never Know is my favorite track here. Might end up being one of my favorite rock singles of the year. I've been listening to this single a ton since it came out. It's just so lovesick sounding, so incredibly heartbroken. And you know what? It sounds fantastic. It's also the catchiest track here. I love how everything here is just a lead up to this huge, guttural chorus that just leaves everything out on the table. I just can't help but get sucked in every time to these long, winding verses. It's fantastic. And Meat Chuck is another great one. Once again, super dreary, very psychedelic. But this one, on the other hand, is one of the gnarliest and meanest sounding tracks here. In a weird way, there's moments on this track that sound out of like the Slint playbook. It's mostly because of that jagged riff and the explosive nature that we get out of nowhere. It's easily one of the heaviest, most pumping tracks here. It's great though. And I love the sort of mysterious side of White Cliffs. I mean, if you dig a lot of the sounds of the early tracks on this album, you're gonna love this. It's bluesy, and the harmonies on this track, easily the best here. Maybe the catchiest as well, and it has this haunting element that honestly would have done this album some good. It just feels like it belongs. This is a really interesting new direction for the Wytches. So like I said, it may not be the Wytches of their first two albums, but they seem more focused. They seem more emotionally driven this time around. And the sort of bluesy garage punk that they bring to the table on this album is really done pretty well. I mean, if I had to make some critiques, it's a little short-winded. I mean, I expected more after 4 years, and the second half of the album isn't nearly as consistent as the first, but if you're a garage punk, garage rock, psychedelic rock head, you're gonna want to listen to this album. I'm feeling a strong 7 on this thing, but let me know what you guys think down below. If you like the video, be sure to give us a like, give us a subscribe, and let me know down below what you would like for me to chat about in the future. And until next time, have a great day, guys.